Hi everyone, welcome to my tutorial on creating a simple slime mesh system. And once again, you can follow along this tutorial with either the Unreal Engine 5 or Unreal Engine 4. So for my example, I have this spline mesh, and it's currently an arrow that's a panning texture arrow. And what you can do is you can extend the spline mesh by pressing Alt and holding down Alt, and on the last point you can drag it out to make another point, and you can pretty much just like tweak it into ways that you want it to be. For example, like a different row systems or like a waypoint system for players to like know where to go. And this can be really handy in for like maybe tower defense games or like racing games where you have like walls of arrows to point where the cars are supposed to go, or to make like simple roads and stuff. Just exchange this texture into a road texture and that'll be fine. So with this system, you can also go into the details, and there are different parameters you can change. And here I have a parameter for color and for glow and for speed. So for color, you can simply just like change the color of the arrows on in my system. Yeah. And for glow, I can increase the glow or decrease it depending on what I want. And for speed, it's just pretty much how fast the panning for the texture is going to be like. Yeah, so I can do it really fast, or I can do it like slow and make it go backwards if I want to. So that's generally what I'm going to teach in this tutorial. And I'm going to split into two parts. One is the making the material, and the other one is making the blueprint for the spine mesh. And like before, I will just like delete whatever I have here and restart from scratch, so I can teach you guys step by step process of how I created this spline mesh system. All right, so starting from scratch, I'm going to create a new folder, and I'm going to call it BP spline mesh. And within this folder, we will need to import the mesh itself and the texture that we're going to use. So I'm going to go ahead and right click and go to import. And I'm going to choose the 3D mesh that I'm going to use and import it in. I can leave everything by default and then just import it in. And then I'm going to go ahead and import the texture itself as well. The mesh I'm using is pretty simple. It's just pretty much a plane. And if I turn on the wireframe of the plane, so you can see that for like a simple plane, there's quite a few poly count in this plane. And the reason is that we need enough segments in this plane in order for the spine mesh to deform and bend smoothly. And also keep in mind that the higher poly count you have, the more it might take away from your computer's processing power. So you want to find a balance to that and not go too crazy on the poly count. As for the UV for the plane, it's a very simple UV. I pretty much just quickly edit it and put it on the bottom of the UV. And so my texture would be like this, where the arrows will be on the bottom half of the texture. And yours will probably be different from mine depending on what kind of model you use and what kind of UV you've done on the model. Next up, I'm going to create the material for the panning arrow. So I'm going to right click and create a new material. I'm going to name this material as M_panning arrow. Let's hop into it. And in the material graph, click on the physical material, and we're going to change the blend mode into translucent and check the two-sided. And within this material, we are basically going to use the base color, the emissive color, and the opacity. And that's pretty much the only three that we're going to touch in this tutorial. For the base color, I'm going to right click and search for a vector parameter. And I'll name this vector parameter as color. And there's also a shortcut for the vector parameter, which you can hold in down V on your keyboard and press the left mouse button. Comes in pretty handy, and if you didn't know, now you know. Next, I'm going to search for texture sample node so that I can use the arrow texture that I have. And the shortcut for this is T plus the left mouse button.
Okay, so I'm going to use my arrow texture that I have onto the texture sample and gonna do a multiply. And I will take the alpha of the texture sample into B. Then let's link the result into the base color. Apply and save. And right now in the preview it's all black because we don't have the opacity in yet. So let's drag the alpha of the texture into the opacity. And you should see the arrows in the texture preview. And I'm going to go ahead and change the color into yellow. And you can change to whatever color you want. So now we see the arrows in the material and we can change the color, but it's not moving. So how do we make it so that the texture can move? It's actually pretty simple. All we need is a panner node. Let's go ahead and right click and search for panner. Add that in, and if you hover over the node and press and hold Alt and Control at the same time, Unreal will like let you know like what this node does. And what the panner node does pretty much is it'll take the U coordinate and the V coordinate of the UV and then just move it around to make a panning moving kind of effect. So within this node, we only need the coordinate and the speed. So let's right click and search for texture coordinate and then hook that up to the coordinate pin. And we can leave this as default. If you want to change the UV tiling, you could do so to get another like different kind of texture effect, texture sizing, if you will. And for the speed, we need a vector 2 constant. So I'm gonna search for vector 2. Oh, my bad, it's constant 2 vector. Yeah. And a shortcut for this is if you press on 2 and then right left click, you can call the constant 2 vector. So let's hook that up to the speed. Now if you look at the details, there's R and G. R pretty much controls the U coordinate of the UV tiling. So if I do like a negative 2, it will go left to right, as you can see on the preview. And if I change the value of G to like 1, it will go from down to up. And this is how we generally want to use to control the panning of our material. For my R, I'm going to use a negative number, because if I use a positive number like 0.55, you can see that it's panning in the wrong direction. So keep in mind when you do this, just make sure like the direction that you're using is the correct way. Here I'm going to use a negative 0.2, and you can see that the panning direction is the way that I want. So I'm going to go apply and save first, and I'll be right back. Okay, the last thing we want to do with the material is to add a glow. Hold down S and left click to add in a scatter parameter, and let's call this glow. And you can also right click and search for scatter parameter as well, so that works too, right here. To have the material glowing properly, we need to multiply the glow with the output of the base color and the texture sample. So let's search for multiply and connect the glow into the B and then connect the output into the emissive color. And with the higher value, the more the glow. So if we bump up the value, it'll be more intense. And if we put it more down, then there'll be less glow, like so. All right, so actually let me show you why we want to use the multiply instead of just simply attaching it. So with this attach, if I just simply change the default value to like maybe like a 2, you can see that it's completely white already, so that's not what we want. And it seems like the emissive is just overtaking the color of the material and making everything white. And we need to make the value very small in order to see our color. That's why we need this multiply to have everything working properly as we intended to do. Alright, so I'm gonna bump up the value to around like 2.6, and then go ahead and apply and save. Alright, let's close this down, and in the main scene, let's drag out the plane into the scene. And let's test the material onto the plane. So let's change the material into the panning arrow, and boom, we have the panning material onto the plane. And right now the glow is kind of small, so I'm going to go back into the material and just change, bump it up into like 20. Yeah. And there's the glow that we want. Actually, I'm gonna go back to the material and show you guys why we need to multiply. So if I do it like this, you can see that the color is gone and it's all white. So that's why we want to have the multiplier. So it's probably better to show it here instead. So there's that. And if you're new to Unreal, if you don't see any glow, that's probably because you don't have a post-processing volume in the scene. And to add that, simply go to the place actors and search for a post-processing volume and just drag it in into the scene. In the details of the post-processing value, there's a few settings that we want to set up. So first we want to have the infinite extend checked. Hold on, let me see where it is. Yeah, here it is. Yeah, so have this checked. If it's unchecked, then everything will be bound inside the box. So you want to have this checked, as you can see. And another setting that we want, if we scroll up, head to bloom right here. And at first it will be unchecked first, so you can check those up and then change the intensity. The higher the intensity, the more bloom you can see in the screen, and I'm just gonna keep it at 0.7 for now. And the next thing is lens third. By default, intensity will be at 1. And it'll look something like this, which is quite a lot of lens flare in my opinion, so I'm gonna just keep it at 0. Okay, so that's pretty much how you make the material for the spline mesh that we are doing. And in the next part of this tutorial, I will show you guys how to make the blueprint for the spline mesh. Thank you everyone for watching. Hopefully you learned something new from this part of the tutorial. And also, never stop learning.